Hello, welcome all. Welcome in ElectronJS course introduction video. And in this video, we will see how this course will help you to create your own desktop application using ElectronJS. So during the course, we are not just going to focus on how to create desktop applications, but we'll also see how we can make it successful using our development efforts. So throughout the course, we are going to follow software development lifecycle, which is the worldwide accepted way to create any new software. So software development lifecycle has multiple phases, which starts with planning phase, where we will plan all the requirements and we will plan what we are going to develop. After planning phase, there is analysis phase where we will analyze all our requirements and we will plan how we're going to implement it. After analysis phase, there is a design phase where we will design user interface of the software, or we will design architecture of the software so that we can implement that in our next phase, which is implementation phase. Now in implementation phase, we will actually start developing our ElectronJS desktop application. Now after done with the basic implementation, there is phase called testing phase. Now this is a really important phase where we will test our application on different platform and different environments. So in this phase, we will get to know that our application is compatible to multiple OS, as well as is it compatible to multiple versions of OS or not. So once our application passed the testing phase, there is a deployment phase where we will notarize our application and we will code sign and notarize our application, and then we will distribute it to the end users. Well, these are all techniques that we will follow to develop our desktop applications. But before that, we got to learn what is ElectronJS and how it is working. For that, let's have a look into course curriculum so that we will get better understanding what this course is up to. So our course will start with introduction, where we will get introduced to ElectronJS and how ElectronJS is working with Chromium and Node.js. We will get basic understanding about how this Electron works. After that, we will learn about how processes works in operating system in general, so that while implementing features in our application, we will get better idea how we can manage processes. After that, we will jump into fundamentals of ElectronJS. Here we will learn about all ElectronJS APIs. We will get introduced to all features that ElectronJS provides, and we will see examples of each of them. After that, we will create music player application using Angular Electron boilerplate. And here we will get introduced to all Angular core concepts, as well as we will see how Electron Angular works together. After that, we will create another application, and this time we will create screen recorder application using Electron React boilerplate. Here also we will get introduced to all basic concepts in React.js and Electron to create any desktop application. And after that, we will try to improve performance of our application. But before improving performance, we will also need to profile our application. So we will see all the techniques that will help us improving performance of our application in this phase. And after that, there is a last phase, which is the deployment phase, where we will learn how to code sign our code and how to notarize our application so that we can start distributing our application to the end users. So this is all about our ElectronJS course. I'm sure after completing this entire course, you'll be able to develop your own cross-platform desktop applications. I think that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. See you in the course. Bye.